prayer for our message on today. Praise the Lord. I read the scripture, praise God, found in Philippians. Forgetting those things which are behind, praise God, reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Praise God. Pressing on. Praise God. Staying productive. Praise God is the thought for today. You may be seated. Praise God. Thank God. Amen. As we brought forth, amen, bringing forth this new year, 2017. Amen. Day, hour, and time that, you know, I'm not clear about. A lot of times at the end of a year, the starting of a new year, I begin to reminisce about, praise God, those that have gone on before us, and those that walked this life, or those that lived, praise God, had an impact on our life and are gone on. There's a lot of people, praise God, good folks, amen, that stood before us, praise God, that have gone on. And there's times in our life where we should do, praise God, what's called kind of an inventory on life. Just to look back, praise God, look at our lives and inventory it out, so to speak. I know every 3 or 4 months in my section at Sounds Club, we got to do our inventory. They say it's inventory time. Sometimes I say, uh-oh, I don't know exactly how things are going to turn out, but hopefully everything's all right. Yes. We ain't missing too much merchandise. Didn't too many things fall through the cracks. Praise God, somebody walk out with too much stuff, but praise God, we do that inventory. We got to count all the merchandise that's in our area. And with me, it's tires and batteries. And a whole lot of tires. Praise God. Amen. So we go through that section, we do that inventory, we sit down and we count up the costs and do the numbers, and that way we see where we're at, and we start from that point and go forward. Praise God. And sometimes that's how life is. Praise God, to look at life, to inventory yourself and say, Lord, I can do better.
Yes.
I can see where you brought me from. I can see the area, praise God, and how far you brought me until this point. But God, hallelujah, I can do, praise God, a little bit better. Yes. I can release a little bit more of myself to your will.
Yes.
I can release a little bit more of myself to your cause. Praise God, whatever it is, whatever door that you want God to open up in your life, if you, praise God, just give him the control, he'll unlock that door,
yes,
praise God, to make a way for you.
Yes.
Praise God, amen. God is pro his people. He's for us.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. I don't care, amen, what the circumstance or what the situation is. Paul here today, he's looking at his life. He looked, praise God, if we go back, if you went back, amen, in the early part of this chapter, praise God, he began to give his life history. Praise God, where he come from. Talked about when he was circumcised. Amen, the 8th day. Praise God, talking about what tribe he come out of. The tribe of Benjamin. Talked about his upbringing. Praise God, how he was raised. Praise God, reading the word of God. Amen. But also talked about how he was displaced. In other words, he didn't get the full understanding of what God went, how he had to go through a change. Praise God. Amen. Before he really began to understand what God was talking about, what this man, amen, called Jesus Christ, who he really is and what he really meant to life. Praise God. And he began to really, amen, lay out his life, do an inventory, praise God, of his life. Amen. About how one day he was apprehended. Do you remember, can you remember a particular point in time, praise God, a particular, just what particular point, where Christ came into your life?
Oh, yes.
Okay, I don't remember that. If you don't remember it, you might have been on this altar.
Yeah. All right.
Praise God. No, that's something, praise God, nobody can do for you. Mm-hmm. Nobody. You have to have a personal experience with Christ. This thing, I mean, as much as it is encouraging in families, as much as encouragement, praise God, in friends and relatives, this thing can't pass off like that.
That's it.
It can't happen like that. You have to have a personal encounter with Christ. And if you're not for sure if you had that personal encounter, praise God, that is where it's at, just like I talked before, have to open up your heart and say, God, come into my heart.
Yes.
Come into my mind. See, you got to do first things first to get the first steps. See, so many people want to come into the church and receive the prophecy over them, receive the blessing over them, receive all the visions over them, but they ain't done first things first.
Right.
They never opened up the door to their heart and say, Lord, you come into my heart. God, you come into my mind. God, you come into my life. You let your spirit flow in me. Praise God. Paul knew all these things. Amen. Studied in the highest schools of his day when it came to religion. Praise God. It was a Pharisee. He was a plebe on his way to be the top Pharisee, the chief Pharisee. Another kafir, so to speak. Man that put Christ to death. He was on his way for the top challenge. He said, I had to count all that as loss because I didn't know him. I missed the point. I went all around this stuff. Praise God. But the one thing I want Christ in my life.
Yes.
You know, he gave up a prestigious life.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
I mean, prestigious life.
Yes, he did.
Praise God. He said, I count all that as done. Imagine folks giving up cars, Mercedes, big time Chrysler, Humvee, praise God, giving up that life, saying, I got to have Christ. If that's going to cost me all of that, so be it. The first thing I got to have is Christ in my life.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And then we'll go from there. Whatever provisions you provide, Lord, however you want me to live, whichever way you want my road to go, praise God, that's the way my road will go. But I've got to have you first in my life. Put Christ first. Praise God. He said, I consider all these things done. Praise God. Amen. That I can win you. Praise God. I remember that day you captivated me. He said, I count not myself to have apprehended. In other words, I didn't apprehend. But this one thing I do, forgetting those things that are behind, I'm reaching forth unto those things which are before. That means I'm stand productive.
Yes.
I'm constantly stand productive in your kingdom. I want your anointing to be on my life. I want your favor to be on my life. Some people think the only time they're supposed to have an anointing on their life is when they sing a song behind the pulpit.
Watch out.
You should be anointed at work.
That's right.
You should be anointed when you go around your friends.
Mm-hmm.
You should be anointed when you're raising your kids. Praise God, my mother used to get real anointed when she got that switch on me when I was
come on now.
Praise God, I now say, don't let that anointing flow like that. My goodness, I don't care where you at and what you're doing. Praise God, you want the anointing of God upon your life.
Yes.
You let it flow. This is not about a show. It's about God being first.
Yes.
That's it.
And God being first in everything. He said, now, you know, Paul said, listen, let this mind, the same mind, be in you that was also in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
Praise God. When I think about the mind, I think about the little story I heard, praise God, about these two monks. You know, monks, they dedicated and give their life only to God. And they walk around in long robes and, you know, almost like priests, but praise God, they're monks. They'll sit for 8 hours in one position and just kneel down and just focus on meditating and whatnot with God. Well, these two monks was on a little journey kind of in a wooded area, praise God. And as these two monks was walking, praise God, they come to this riverbank. And inside at this riverbank, praise God, that they came to, they seen this young lady, young Japanese lady, praise God, and she was just standing by the riverbank. Somebody's gonna miss this. She was standing by the riverbank, praise God. And one monk said, "Ma'am, you look like you kind of lost, kind of disturbed. What's wrong?" And she said, "I gotta get across this river, because I'm scared to get in that water." And the monk said, "Listen, that water's not that deep. We cross this all the time. It's just about waist high." She said, "Yeah, but I'm just terrified of going in that river. And the monk said, "Listen, you just get up on my shoulders and I'll carry you across the river." And the lady said, "Whoa, I could probably do that." And God jumped up on the monk's shoulders and the monk walked this lady completely across the river. They got on the other side, the monks, and she put the lady down, and the lady really thanked him, praise God, and went on her way. And the monks went on their way after they crossed the river. And a little piece down the road, one monk said to the other one, "Got a bone to pick with you." And the monk said, "What?" He said, "Yeah, I got a bone to pick with you." He said, "About what?" He said, "About that woman." He said, "What about that woman?" He said, the other monk said, "We're monks. We don't touch women and we don't talk to women. But you went up there," and he said, wait a minute, "that woman needed help. I helped that woman, put her on my shoulders, and I carried her across the river, and I put her down. You, on the other hand, is still carrying her in your mind." Your mind has to be changed.
All right.
See, amen. A lot of folks don't understand it's the mindset behind what's going on.
Yes.
That's why I said, "Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus." Mm-hmm. Amen. And when you stand productive, when you're pressing on, when you stand active for the Lord, that's why I said, "I press toward the mark." Praise God. Reaching for those things which are before. And praise God. Amen. Reaching forth unto those things which are before. Praise God. He's standing actively. He's pressing. Praise God. He's looking for what God would have him to do next. Uh-huh. He look for what God, what's the next move? Amen, so to speak, on the chessboard of life. What's your next move? What plans have you made? What do you desire to do? Praise God. What do you desire to achieve, to accomplish, to become, to whatever it is, for the glory of God?
Amen.
Do you know your desire should be for God's glory? I don't care what it is.
That's it. That's it.
Hallelujah. On the air talked about, praise God, going to the Navy. Her heart was all in it. All the way, praise God. Amen. And when she got home, praise God, she was a bit confused because things didn't go out. But God's got another avenue.
That's right.
Amen. God had something else planned.
That's it.
God's got another road, praise God. Want to encourage, amen, amen, for, amen, them to do what God has for you to do as you lay out your life. A young lady I used to work with, she mentioned she was married and had two kids, and praise God, amen. I was pretty involved in the church and she knew, praise God. She knew me before I was a preacher, knew after I started preaching, praise God, amen, and whatnot. But the question she had was, "I wonder what it is God want me to be. What is it God want me to do?" She came to me with that question one day. I don't know, see, Gary, you got your life kind of figured out, you on that path, but what am I supposed to do? I don't feel like I know what I'm supposed to do. And I looked at her and I called her name and I said, Dan, what are you talking about? She said, yeah, what you're supposed to do is, to me, it's obvious. She said, what do you mean? I said, no way would God bless you with two kids. No way would he bless you with those kids. Amen. And not expect for you to bring them up in the right manner. Mm-hmm. Not expect you to raise your family. I said, he gave you the gift of those. You're supposed to be the best mom, the best mother that you can be for your child. You're supposed to step up to the plate, make sure they have what they need, nurture them, care for them, be there for them, pray God, raise them up, be there for them, pray God. I'm reaching out to strangers. God gave you your own personal family. Praise God, he's there. You don't know what to do. Yeah, I never looked at them like that. Praise God. Sometimes what we're supposed to is right there before our face.
That's right.
Hallelujah, looking at us right in the face. You can be very productive, praise God, in your home, in your household, in this church, and in this ministry. Let the Lord use you, praise God, for that area that he desires to use you in. Praise God. Look back, praise God, sometime to see the good things that God has done. Praise the Lord. God has done, praise God, some good things in our life. Amen. But stand productive. Amen. Seeking out what he wants us to do. Staying busy. Praise God for the Lord. Amen. When you stay busy, you ain't got time to worry about sometimes you get the land down and get that spread out everything. As soon as I get back, I'm going to just chill out and do this and do that for, you know, that mindset will take you over.
Come on now.
But when you're busy for the Lord, my goodness. I've worked 8 hours every day, and some days it seems like, praise God, those 8 hours go by so fast.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And when we're not busy, you're talking about time distracting.
Amen.
I mean, just drag on. I say, with a thunder day. Praise God. The shop will work in, the person walk back, come back and forth to that same door about 5 times. I say, man, you need to find something to do. We're talking about it. Praise God. Amen. But then that's how it is. God will always have something for if we seek the Lord. Amen, for what he called us to do. Praise God, and start with that mind.
Mm-hmm.
I'm about to talk about the change of heart. Speaking positive.
Yes.
You gotta speak positive in every area, every situation. I'm not trying to blindside or hold or make things seem like they're not or whatnot, but so many times we can speak positive over our situation. I wouldn't want to go into work every day and say, man, I don't like this job. I'm sick of this job. I'm sick of these folks. We need to go. You need to find another place.
Mm-hmm.
You need to go somewhere where you can speak positive.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Hey, man. They come up to me from time to time. I see them folks. They care how long you've been here. Praise God. I say, I've been here a good while. I don't know you're going to be here. I say, I'm going to be here until I quit or until I leave.
That's right. Amen.
No, I don't hesitate when they say that. How long have you been at your job? I've been out there 25, 30 years. 30 years, let me tell you. Praise God. God make a way.
Yes.
You take, praise God, pride in where you at. I don't care where you at. Praise God. Amen. You have to speak to yourself in the mirror and say, I am somebody.
That's right.
Praise God. Say, I am somebody. I'm going to make a way. Praise God. God is going to make a way. Amen. God knows. Amen. Stand productive. Amen. Pressing on toward the mark of that high calling which is in Christ Jesus. Amen. We thank the Lord for that. Thank God for the things that he's doing.
Yes,
praise
yes,
the Lord. God is good. Give him a hand.